Here is a visualization of our Stanford Racing Car Junior in action, applying that exact same algorithm for actual driving. And you can see here that a right turn is being executed, followed by a lane shift. These are discrete actions, and the car actually performs those to reach a goal location at the orange circle. But if we make a lane shift prohibitively expensive, just as we made a left turn expensive before, then the car chooses a different path. It goes straight, then takes a left turn, which right now isn't that expensive, and it takes a left turn and a left turn again to find itself in the lane where the goal location is located. That is a result of modifying cost functions in our dynamic programming algorithm in the same 3D regime we just studied and that you just programmed. So your program could effectively drive this car, and by changing these cost functions, as you can see over here, the car would be able to attain its goal in the optimal way relative to the costs that you have given him. So congratulations, you made it through my first motion class. Today we assume that the world is discrete, and we looked at two planning algorithms, A star, which uses a heuristic to find a path, and dynamic programming, which finds an entire policy. That is a plan for every location. We implemented both of them. In fact, in the policy case, even in 3D, which is quite an achievement. And I want to congratulate you to get here. You really now understand two of the main paradigms by which our robots make motion decisions. And there are also some very major paradigms for artificial intelligence in general. In next class, we talk about how to turn this into actual robot motion. So we talk about continuous state spaces, and we talk about what's called control, in which we make a robot move. I'll see you next week.